Good morning, everyone, and it's a beautiful Friday morning. I'm meeting you. How are you keeping? How has your week been so far? I hope you had a great week. So we were talking about nodal verbs. We started it 2 weeks ago, and we were talking about the can and the could and the would, may, might, must, should, could have, should have, may have, must have to, be able to. We had a lot of things, right? I mean, a lot we covered under modal verbs. So modal verbs are very important, so we covered most of it. So today I'm going to do a summary and end the lesson, because if you feel like, okay, I haven't touched this on the episodes on TV, you can of course go to our YouTube channel and watch it and learn from it, because I know for a fact that we have weavers who make notes and study the content we teach here. So this is for you. If you feel like you've missed it, or if you really need to revise it, then go back to our lesson, watch it and learn from it, because modal verbs are very important in day-to-day conversations, in writing, in anything you do. If it is English, because the tasks or the duties the modal verbs can perform, the main verbs cannot do that. And of course, the structure is very easy. So today I'm going to take a summary of modal verbs, what we've covered during the past 3 weeks. And I'm actually not going to touch base on the structure, because in every lesson using modal verbs, we were talking about the structure and we were practicing or doing activities, exercises for the structure as well. So I'm not going to do the structures today, but I'm going to show you when to use the modal verbs, just as a recap, so that you'll know what you've missed. Okay, right. Look at the screen. So modal verb structure, we started the modal verbs with the most common modal verb you use in English, that is the word can, right? Can. So can is for possibility. Possibility. Possibility kiyanne puluwang kamak tiyana deyak. Pol puluwang yamak puluwang, right? We can see the team now. Apita team ekak peenawa. Me welaye mata team ekak dakinna puluwang kamak tiyana. We can. Can. So can is like, we easily use can in our conversations. We can see the team now. Oh, I can see her. We can do that. Karanna puluwang. We can do it. We can do it. Possibility. And of course, with that, allowed and ability. Ability, possibility, both like, both look alike. Right? Possibility karanna puluwang de. Ability karanna haki de. Right? I can do that. I can sing. You can dance very well. You can dance very well. What hundred dance karanna puluwang ne. You dance very well. We are hundred dance karanava. But you can dance very well. What hundred dance karanna puluwang ne. You're talking about an ability. Right? You're talking about an ability karanna puluwang de. You can come in. You are allowed to come in. What athulta enna puluwa. This is particularly not about what he can do and what is possible and what he is able to do, but it is about your giving permission. Can ekak api me wage tarang bara naha namuth can eken eke tikak ara hita ganna ba me kiyanne puluwan kiyala da ehema natha me mata avasara deema da eke echchara ehema danaganna onne a meka avasara denawa a meka mata puluwan de ehema avasara onne නමුත් අර මතක තියාගෙන කැන්ට මේ තුනම කරන්න පුළුවන්. ඒකයි කැන්ව කැන්ට ගොඩක් වැඩ කරන්න පුළුවන්. කැන්. හරි ලේසි. So can I go now? It's like asking for permission. නැතවට සමහර කෙනෙක්ට කියන්න පුළුවන් මේ can I go now එක හරියට නිකන් මට ඒක කරන්න පුළුවන් දහන එක වගේ එකක් නේ. Am I able to do it? No problem. ඒක කොයි විදිහට හිතුවත් ඒ මොකක් හරි වාට කරන්න පුළුවන් ද කියන එක තමයි හන්නේ. So can you use in that sense, right? It was about possibility, allowed, whether you're allowed or not, whether you have permission to do it or not, and of course the ability. And then we had this can doesn't have a future. Now can has a past. Can ge past එක තමයි could කියන්නේ. Let me see whether I have included that here. So can doesn't have a future. When you say can do something, let's say you say I can dance, she can dance, right? She can dance. Then mata onnang meyata heta natanna puluwan weda ada natanna ba But she can dance tomorrow. Ah, that is different. Then either puluang me kiyana kare me mama kiyanne. Meyata avasara thiyenawa. Eka. She can dance tomorrow. Hete yata karanna puluwan. Not that. I'm talking about mata yamak issarahata karanna puluwan vey. Hakiyawa labei anagathayedi. Ah. අනිත් අවුරුද්දේ මට ඒක කරන්න පුළුවන් වෙයි. මොන හරි මං අනිත් අවුරුද්දේ මට ඒක කරන්න පුළුවන් වෙන දැන් වෙනකොට කරමින් ඉන්නවා. ඒක පුළුවන් නම් මට කැන්දාලා කියන්න බෑ. So අන්න එතන තියෙනවා be able to. Look at the screen. So that is where you need your I am able to. Or not I am able to, I will be able to. I will be able to dance මට කරන්න පුළුවන් වෙයි. Future එකේදී මට කරන්න පුළුවන් වෙන දෙයක්. Right? I will be able to do something next year. I will be able to because I'm studying the dancing lessons now, so I will be able to dance. Mata puluwan vei. So we were talking about it. Mata yamak puluwan vei anagathayedi karanda hakiyawa labei. So could general past. Can eke mata kiyanna ona athitayedi mata karanna puluwan vela tibba deyak. Right? Then you need your could. Was able to for a specific past. Then me deke yavilla venasa. Then wa kiyadi I can dance. This is your present. So I was talking about this in detail. So I can dance. Present ekedi mata puluwan dance karanna. Mata onnan kiyanne e kale mata dance karanna puluwan vela tibuna. You say I could dance. Me godak ayata waraddana tanak. පාස්ට් එකේදී කියනකොට දැන් හිතන්න මට ගිය අවුරුද්දේ කරන්න පුළුවන් වෙලා තිබ්බ එකක් මම දැන් කියන එක නේද සමහර අය කියනවා I can dance last year I can dance මේ මං කියන්නේ මේක I can dance last year it's wrong I can dance last year කියන්නේ පාස්ට් එකේ එක ගිය අවුරුද්දේ මට dance කරන්න පුළුවන්කම තිබුණා නෑ I could dance I could dance last year. Mata giya avuruddi dance karanna puluwan kama thibuna. I could dance last year. Right. Was able to for specific past. Ekeni samahara welawata ogolo dakala thi. I was able to dance wage ekak kiyena. They were very specific about it. Hitanna. So last year we had this annual general meeting. So I was able to dance there. I was able to do a speech. I was able to mata e annual general meeting ekedi පුළුවන් කම ලැබුණ ස්පීච් එකක් කරන්න. ඒකෙන් මම කියන්නේ මගේ ජීවිත කාලේ මට ඒක පුළුවන් වෙලා තිබුණා දේ කාලේ ඒ නෙවෙයි. කුඩ් එක ඉන් ජෙනරල්. මේවා අපි ඉන් ඩීටේල් කතා කරා. මේ ගිහිලා බලන්න. But when you say I was able to do something or he was able to do something, she was able to do something, they were able to do something, very situation. It's situational. It's according to the situation you use be able to. Past එකේදී, right? මේක ගැන අපි කතා කරා. And then we had can and could for requests. Can you give me that book? Can you lend me the book? Could you lend me the book? When it comes to like, you can use can and could. Now, this is not about present ability and past ability, not about that. This is about using can and could to request things. Can you lend me the book? Could you lend me the book? Can you lend me the book? It's not very formal, it's casual. You use it with your friends, family. But when you ask, could you lend me the book? That is formal and polite. Right? Formal and polite. So if you want to make it very polite, you can of course add you possibly. Could you possibly lend me the book? Mithanta dala puluang use karana me penane. So you make it very formal and very polite. Right? Me vagan apikata kara. Right. Could you possibly do something for me? And then we had could have. This is the modal perfect of could, right? Modal perfect. So could have gone there. Puluwan kama thibilat kale nathi deval. Puluwan kama thibuna habai kare ne. So it was possible, but you didn't do it, or it didn't happen. Puluwan kama thibilat kale nathi deval damai. Api oya could have dala pavichi karane. You could have done that. They could have played well. She could have eaten that. He could have studied hard. I could have gone there. Puluwan kama thibuna yanda koyeda giye nae ne. Puluwan kama thibilat kare nathi dewal. You use could have, right? Could have. And meka echchara sara nae. You lightly say ayyo puluwan kama thibilat kare nae ne yane. Meka sara gatiya wedi ekak enawa. Eka thamai should have kiyala api igena gatte me sathiyemai should have thibune. So Kudami is all about Puluwan kamathi bilat kare nati deval gana. It was possible, but you didn't do it. And then we had the may structure. So may is all about perhaps samahara vitta vei. Right, possibility ekak tiyanawa deyak wenna like your probability ekak mokari deyak wimata thi sambhavithawa hakiyawa tibeda nadda kiyana eka thamai me walin kiyanne. Right, Sara may be ill. Sara leading wenda athi. Sara leading wenda athi. Right, Sara may come. Sara samahara vita ei. Samahara vita Sara ei. Are you sure about it? No. Wenda puluwa wenda hakiyawak tiyana like it's a probability. Right, probability eka wenna hakiyawak tiyenawa novennat hakiyawak tiyenawa depattak tiyenawa kathawata. You are not sure about it. And Sara Sara isil. Sara isil kiyana eka oya sure. Sara ledin meka sure. Sara ledin kiyana eka sure. But when you say Sara may be ill, ledin wenna athi, you are assuming, you are assuming. So it's about me. Tesi metanath ekkama enawa must kiyana modal verb eka. Eka balamu break ekin passe api meewa tamai giya sathiye study kare. So this week we had the may have and the must have, but before that let's go for a break and then talk about the rest we had. Welcome after the break, and you're with Adha Dharan Education English Council. We were talking about can, could, shall, should, would, could have, should have, would have, may have, might have, must have. So now we are summarizing everything. So during the past 3 weeks, we were talking about these modal verbs. So yeah, we are here. May kiyana eka structure thi mona hari miss una nan, if you have missed the episodes on TV, of course you can watch us on YouTube. Adha Dharan Education English Council Phase 3 is our YouTube channel. Right, okay. So Sara may be ill, Sara may come, right? Sara is ill kiyana kota Sara ledin, you're sure about it, look at the screen. But when you say Sara may be ill, ledin wenda athi, you're not sure about it. Samahara vita ehema wenda athi, you're like assuming. So may might ethakkama enawa me vidiyatama might danna puluwan sentence ekata habai wenasak tiyenawa because possibility of might is uncertain than may kiyanne oya den kiyadi Sara may be ill Sara ledin wenna athi there is a chance which is 60% there is a chance for that to happen the chance is 60% but when you say might when you use might in the same sentence might kiyana ekata like you're not very sure about it you're not very certain about it you're assuming things both like using may and might you assume things but when you use might there is only 20% of likelihood for this to happen Sara might be ill right you're not so sure about it So Sara might be ill is there is only 20% of chance that she is ill. But when you say Sara may be ill, there is like 60 to 70% of a chance where Sara is ill. Right? Okay. So eka tamai wenasa e hinda eka hondata mataka tiyagena mege might ge. And then we had must when talking about assumptions and talking about how certain you are about certain assumptions. Must ekak hondatama sure wedi sure pattata wedi Sara must be ill kiyenakota me tai mai tai dekata wada oya sure aniwaryen Sara ledin wenna thi right Sara got caught in the rain yesterday she must be ill ehana ada sure ledin wenna thi Sara must be ill must ekak enakota bara wedi wenna oy ekama meke ilagada ogolo may have might have must have enakota to ekama vidiyata thamai theruma wenas wenne right must kiyenakota eka You're very sure and certain about it. Right. So she may do it, she may have done it. Then she may do it, it's in the present and in the future. She may do it. එමනම් ඉස්සරහට කරන්න ඉඩ තියෙනව හැකියාව තියෙනවා. Possible, right? It, your assumption is in the present or in the future. හරි, she may do it. ඒක කරා. හැබැයි she may have done it කියලා යාක කරලා ඇති. Now this is in the past. Right? Past එකේ තියෙන්නේ she may have. Present එකේ future එකේ තමයි තියෙන්නේ she may do it. එයා එක කරයි, එයා එක කරලා ඇති. She may have done it. So you cannot use just like she may did it. එහෙම කියලා අපි කියන්නේ නැහැ. She may have done it. එයා එක කරලා ඇති. She may have done it. She may have done it. We had the structure. Also we studied the structure as well. මේ ඇවිල්ලා මේකේ modal perfect එක. She may did it. එහෙම කියන්නේ නැහැ. She may do it. Present and the future. She may have done it. එයා එක කරලා ඇති. Are you sure about it? Well, again, 60 to 70%. So that's why you have strong assumption in the past. මොකද්ද? ඔන්න may have වෙනුවට must have වෙන්නේ ওই වෙලාවට. මේට වඩා must එක strong වගේ. So she may be ill. She must be ill. There is a difference. Right? අනිවාර්යෙන් ledding වෙන්න ඕනේ. She must be ill. Must have වත් අනිවාර්යෙන් ledding ඉන්නේ නැති. Sure. She must have been ill. She must have been ill. She must have been ill. Must have එක sure පැත්තට වැඩි. You're very so certain about your assumption. You're very certain. I'm sure that she was ill. I'm sure that she was ill. And now, hundred percent sure, I am not leading. In that, she must have been ill, right? This is the difference. Strong assumption in the past, right? Oya den giyanang hundai. Then we had the structure. Oya den giyanang hundai. That is, you'd better go, or you'd kiyanne, you had. You had කියන එකම you had කියන එක කියනම අඩුයි අපි you had better go කියලා කියන්නේ අපි සාමාන්‍යයෙන් you'd she'd he'd we'd I'd they'd එක contract කළාම තමයි කියන්නේ so you'd better go now well, then ගියා නම් හොඳයි if you don't go you'll have to face the repercussions usually it's about like when you use had better or you'd better do something if you don't do it, you will have negative consequences of not doing it. And it's about like do it now, otherwise something bad will happen. Model like yani you'd better do it. That's the best thing to do now. Samahara naraka deyak wen ekak na namuth that's the best thing to do now. You'd better do it. Right? You'd better do it. Ehinda kaata hari ara politely kiyanna ona me eka kaloth hondai. ඒකට you'd better use කරන්න එපා politely ආ ඒක කළොත් හොඳයි you should do it this is how you like advise someone now advising you use you'd better to advise someone of course you should the you'd better වෙනුවට should දාන්න අපි advise කරනකොට අර ටිකක් you'd better කියන එක මේ වෙලාවේදී ඔයා මේ කළොත් හොඳයි otherwise you will have to face the consequences of not doing it හැබැයි ඒක අර ටිකක් පාවිච්චි කරන්න එපා බොසස් ලැක්ක ටීචර්ස් ලැක්ක ටිකක් ඔගේ ඔෆිස් එකේ ලොකුවත් එක පාවිච්චි කරන්න එපා you'd better do it you'd better send me the email වගේ ලොකු ලොක්කට බොස්ට කියන්න යන්න එපා because it's not very polite right it's not very polite so ඒක ගැන අපි කතා කරා and then we had this should and must එතකොට should මේ එකම modal verb එක 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 තැන්වල use වෙනවා ඒකයි මේ තියෙන්නේ දැන් එකම දෙයට නෙමෙයි modal verb එකෙක් වැඩ ගොඩක් ගන්න පුළුවන්. Now here should and must the difference is if someone or like recommend or if someone ask you to do something using should of course you have a choice. You should not go there. කවුරු හරි කිව්වා කියලා හිතන්නකෝ. You should not go there. එහෙම නැත්නම් you should go there. ආ වහේ යන්න ඕනේ. You should go there. Or you should not go there. එහෙ යන්න එපා. You should not එහෙ යන්න එපා. You should not. You should go there. ඕනේ එක. But when it comes to advice or recommendation must is very strong if someone says you must go there yanda mone it's like you don't have any choice wage right you have to go there it's like you aren't obligation you should must to talk about obligations necessity is it compulsory for me to do it yes it is compulsory if someone says must ekakin wada deyak kiyana you must do it කියනකොට එකයි මෙතන දැමන්නේ you should stop smoking of course you can stop or you can like keep smoking but if someone says you must obey the law එක අනිවාර්යෙන්ම ඔයා කළ යුතුයි මස්ට් එක ආ ඒක ටිකක් අනිවාර්ය පැත්තට බාරයි right and then we had should have is again to advise someone not advise sorry to talk about regrets and to talk about of course to advise මේක චුට්ටක් අර could have ට වඩා could have කියන්නේ පුළුවන්කම තිබිලා කළේ නැති දෙවනි should have කියන්නේ කරන්න යුතුව තිබිලා කළේ නැහැ එහෙම නැත්නම් වැරදි දෙයක් කරන්න පස්සේ අපි අවවාද කරන තැන් දෙකක් so we were talking about this in detail I'm just showing you a glimpse of it so he should have done it එක කරන්න යුතුව තිබුණා හැබැයි ඒක කළේ නැහැ කළා නැති වෙලාවට තමයි අපි මේක යූස් කරන්නේ I should have read that shit මට කියවන්න තිබුණා මම මටම ඇඩ්වයිස් කරගන්න සමහනි should have තමයි දාන්නේ කොට පුකුඩ වෙක ඇච්චර බර නැහැ ඇඩ්වයිස් එකේදී අපි should have එක ටිකක් බරයි right ඉතින් බර අවශ්‍ය විදියට පාවිච්චි කරන්න පුළුවන් right එක්කො You did something wrong. Oh, I shouldn't have spoken to you. I shouldn't have. I mean, when you do something wrong, the only option is this. Shouldn't have. Right? I shouldn't have done it. Oh, I shouldn't have spoken to you. I shouldn't have called her. You did something wrong and you regret. You advise yourself. Or you can, of course, advise someone else. Right? Okay. Either should have, shouldn't have. ඊළඟට අපිට would තිබුණා. අපි ඉවර කළේ would වලින්. මොකද would එකේ would you like some tea? When you like want to offer something, would you like some tea? Yes, please. Or I'd like to have coffee. මම නම් කෝපි වලට කැමති. මේකෙදී අපි කතා කරා මේ would එක ඕනෙමද මෙතනට දාන්න. Do you like tea කියලා අහන එකේ අහන්නේ මගෙන් කවුරුරි ඇහුවොත් කෝපි වලට කැමතිද? Okay. You can say Yes, I like tea. Ethaning what offer karana neme. Offer karanna ahannone would you like kiyala. Do you like kiyala ahanne? Oya kemathida? Oya kemathida kiyala ahanne. Offer karana mama neme ne. Right? Habe ethe meke echchara apita therenawa. Te eka gedata gihila waadi una passe do you like tea or coffee? Eme kiyala ahanakota ah dan me denna thamai yanne te kiyala therenawa. E unata hariyata offer karana widi would you like tea or would you like to have some coffee? Oh, I'd like some tea. Edara metandi ara I'd Like coffee and I like coffee කියන එකේ වෙනසක් තියෙනවා කියලා මං කිව්වා. මොකද I like coffee that is oh I'd like to have it. I'd prefer that. මේ situational මේ වෙලාවේදී මට තේ කූපි offer කරාම මං හොඳ wood එක දාලා කිව්වම තමයි මගේ offer එක මම හරි solidly කියන okay I'd like to have it. But when you say I like coffee that is in general මන්න කෝපි වලට තමයි ආස. That's in general. මං සාමාන්‍ය පොදුවේ කෝපි වලට ආසයි. But when you say I'd like coffee පොදුවේ මං කෝපි වලට ආසද නැද්ද වැඩක් නැහැ මට මේ වෙලාවදී තින් ඔය ඔෆර් කරන්නේ කෝපි නම් ඕකේ I'd like coffee What would you like to have What would you like to have I'd like some coffee මං කෝපි වලට පොඩක් කෝපි කැමති කෝපි වලට කැමති මං කෝපි එකක් බොන්නම් දැන් මීදින් එකේ තමයි යා Okay so that was about modal verbs so we are done with modal verbs if you missed any of our episodes on TV of course you can watch us on YouTube Other than an education, the English Council, phase 3, you have all our grammar lessons lined up on the YouTube channel, so you can watch it and of course comment. And I personally read your comments, so comment and send us your feedback. If you'd like to learn something, of course tell us. Let's have a viewers week for grammar as well. I'm going to include that in between my lessons. So let's have a viewers week. ඔගලුන්ගේ questions අපි දාලා අපේ lessons ටිකක් Thank you.